Bookkeeping and record keeping. Annual budget. Each booster club should produce an annual budget according to the procedure outlined in its current bylaws. The budget should list a line item for each anticipated source of income and expense, and may serve to assist in creating and maintaining a chart of accounts for bookkeeping purposes. Each line item or account may be income only, expense only, or a combination of both. For example, a donations line item will only list an estimate of cash donations expected to be received during the year. A general supplies line item may only list an estimated total expense for office supplies and other basic items not intended for any other specific purpose. Line items dedicated to fundraising events should list estimated income and expenses, such as the expected gross receipts collected from plate sale tickets and the expected cost of paper goods, food ingredients, permits, food safety items, etc. The ending balance for each line item should also be listed. Line items dedicated to fundraising events should list estimated income and expenses, such as the expected gross receipts collected from plate sale tickets and the expected cost of paper goods, food ingredients, permits, food safety items, etc. The ending balance for each line item should also be listed. Your club's budget should be evaluated continuously to ensure that the executive board is aware of the progress of its activities and able to take any corrective action necessary. Some clubs' bylaws allow for budget changes at any time throughout the year. Others require that a mid-year budget review take place. It is highly recommended that your budgets are approved by the General Assembly at any regularly scheduled meeting. Also, your bylaws should outline a policy for emergency expenditures. This way, your club's overall spending is based upon the approval of the entire club, but the Executive Board still maintains somewhat of a safeguard for emergency situations. Bookkeeping software. It is extremely important that 501c3 organizations maintain complete and accurate financial records. This includes a general ledger, original receipts, invoices, purchase orders, checks, etc., periodic financial reports, original copies of federal and state tax-related filings, documentation of internal and external financial audits, bank statements, etc. The easiest way to satisfy most of these requirements is to turn to electronic bookkeeping software. PBUSA provides a new cloud-based solution called PBUSA Briefcase. Unfortunately, this new service just launched this summer, and there's no reviews, demos, or tutorials available to evaluate its effectiveness. Other solutions include the industry standard Intuit's QuickBooks. QuickBooks is available in a multitude of versions, each capable of running multiple editions for specific users. QuickBooks Premier offers industry-specific features, including nonprofits. QuickBooks Premier for nonprofits includes a default chart of accounts tailored for nonprofits, a budgeting feature, custom financial reports, including a tax summary report, detailed tracking of all income and expense sources, and more. Best of all, it allows you to scan original receipts and other documents and attach them to transactions, vendor donor accounts, or even your company information record. Despite common belief, digital scans of original documents are acceptable when presenting records for audit or review, provided that they are clearly legible and accurate. Tip: if using a scanner that implements optical character recognition, or OCR, you must review the interpreted data and make any necessary corrections in your financial records, especially if that data is to be imported into QuickBooks or any other digital solution. The retail cost of QuickBooks Premier 2014 for a single user license is $399.95. Intuit ProAdvisor partners are able to provide 25, 30, or 35% discounts depending on their ProAdvisor status. A less expensive option is the new QuickBooks Online, or QBO, service, a cloud-based version of the QuickBooks software that also supports nonprofits and is available as a monthly subscription. QBO offers three editions ranging from $12.95 a month to $39.95 a month and enables you to more easily share access to your company file with all executive officers, booster members, and outside accountants, bookkeepers when necessary. Each user can have a different level of access based on preferences that you set. If choosing QuickBooks Premier, the best option for nonprofits is to take advantage of the Intuit donation program offered by the Intuit Financial Freedom Foundation and available through the TechSoup website. Requires membership and proof of 501c3 tax-exempt status. Discounted prices for QuickBooks Premier are $45 for a single-user license, $99 for a three-user license. Additional licenses required for simultaneous multi-user access to a single company file. QuickBooks for Mac 2014 also supports nonprofits and is available for $25. Eligible clubs may purchase one QuickBooks product per year, allowing it inexpensive access to the most current version each year. Even with the huge discounts available to nonprofits purchasing QuickBooks, you may choose to opt for a free alternative instead. While not as full-featured as QuickBooks, the open-source program GNU Cash is multi-platform, available under the GNU General Public License, and a great choice for desktop-based software. GNU Cash is capable of importing and converting QuickBooks data and opening QuickBooks company files. Great options for anyone looking to cut costs by migrating away from QuickBooks. Although there are no specific features tailored to nonprofits, its job tracking feature can be used to track fundraisers, and you can always export data into Excel to create custom financial reports. Some clubs may find these extra efforts worth the zero price tag. A better free option is Wave Accounting, or just known as Wave, an alternative to QBO that provides more robust features than GNU Cash. Wave provides many of the same advantages as QBO, including online and multi-user access and custom settings for nonprofits. QBO still offers more, but Wave does also provide free unlimited support. Credit and debit card processing and payroll support are also available at very affordable prices compared to similar QuickBooks add-on services provided by Intuit. Financial reports. Financial reports are key to understanding your club's cash flow thoroughly, providing you with the valuable information necessary to make sound decisions and evaluate the effectiveness of your fundraising activities. The QuickBooks and Wave products previously mentioned include all the reports necessary for nonprofit organizations like yours. Financial reports may also be requested by federal and state agencies, financial institutions, or internal auditors. The most important financial reports are your monthly treasurer's reports, that is, based on your general ledger, and your tax summary report at the end of the tax year. The tax summary report provides the totals needed to complete your tax filing requirements. With an effective chart of accounts in place, proper data entry, and accurate tax line mapping in your software, your tax summary report provides quick, accurate accounting for each line in your tax return. Record retention policy. From the IRS Compliance Guide for 501c3 Public Charities. Record retention periods vary depending on the types of records and returns. Permanent records. Some records should be kept permanently. These include the application for recognition of tax-exempt status, the determination letter recognizing tax-exempt status, and organizing documents such as articles of incorporation and bylaws, with amendments, as well as board minutes. Employment tax records. If an organization has employees, it must keep employment tax records for at least 4 years after the date the tax becomes due or is paid, whichever is later. Records for non-tax purposes. When records are no longer needed for tax purposes, an organization should keep them until they are no longer needed for non-tax purposes. For example, a grantor, insurance company, creditor, or state agency may require that records be kept longer than the IRS requires. Excerpts from Texas CBAR's Nonprofit Legal Toolkit. Nonprofits must keep correct and complete books and records. All nonprofits must maintain the following information at the registered or principal office of the nonprofit in Texas. names and addresses of members, if any, entitled to vote, the written consent of the registered agent, minutes of meetings of members, boards of directors, and any committees having the authority of the board of directors, and complete books and records of accounts. Nonprofits must keep true and accurate financial records. Records should contain full and correct entries, including income and expenditures, in accordance with generally accepted accounting principles. The records must be kept at the registered or principal office of the nonprofit in Texas for at least 3 years after the close of the fiscal year. Nonprofits should maintain and destroy records and files according to a written archival policy. This policy should also cover email and voicemail. If the nonprofit knows of pending or threatened litigation, any document destruction should be curtailed. It is a felony to falsify or destroy a document with the intent to obstruct an investigation of any branch of the federal government. See texascbar.org for a sample document retention policy. Most nonprofits that receive contributions from sources outside their membership in excess of $10,000 during a fiscal year must maintain additional documents and make them available to the public. Nonprofits do not need to disclose the names of donors. Nonprofits must prepare an annual report of financial activity for the preceding year. Nonprofits must prepare or approve an annual report that must include a statement of support, revenue and expenses, changes in fund balances, a statement of functional expenses, and balance sheets for all funds. The report must conform to accounting standards as promulgated by the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants. Members of the public may copy publicly available documents during normal business hours. Nonprofits do not have to disclose the names of members or contributors. A nonprofit may charge for the reasonable expense of preparing a copy of a record or report. Failure to maintain financial records, prepare an annual report, or make the records available to the public is a Class B misdemeanor under state law. There are additional penalties under federal law. Note, the Internal Revenue Code also requires that the three most recent annual information returns, Forms 990, be available for public inspection. Nonprofits must allow the Attorney General to examine books and records. The Attorney General of Texas may inspect all the books and records of the nonprofit. The Attorney General may investigate an organization to determine if it is in violation of its governing documents. Failure to allow the Attorney General to examine or copy records is a Class B misdemeanor under state law and may lead to penalties, forfeiture of property, and additional criminal charges. Nonprofits must allow any member or governing person to examine and copy books and records, including the names and addresses of members entitled to vote. A member can make a written demand to examine the nonprofit's books and records. The purpose of the demand must be stated in writing. The member or member's agent, attorney, or accountant may examine the books at any reasonable time and for any proper purpose. The cost of copying is the responsibility of the member. Nonprofits with employees must keep extensive records in accordance with numerous employment laws. Different employment laws apply to nonprofits depending on the number of full and part-time employees. Record-keeping requirements vary under each law. A good rule of thumb is to keep all payroll information, including time cards, sick and other leave, overtime, and payment history for at least 4 years. Keep records of work-related injuries and illnesses for at least 5 years. Nonprofit directors and staff must file correct documents. A person who signs or directs the filing of a false document is liable for damages, court costs, attorney's fees, and criminal offenses.